Hello, dear parents. Good afternoon. Okay, welcome to the let's start our workshop now. It's 1:30 already. So let's start our workshop from now. Welcome to the parents workshop, fun way to learn Chinese. And this workshop will have 2 sections. The section one will be me printing for two of you. The time will be from 1:30 to 2:10, and then I will pass this meeting to Mr. Huang, and he will continue. Okay. So this topic of this workshop is fun way to learn Chinese. It's quite a big topic, right? And this workshop will focus on the learn Chinese character, which is the most difficult part for learning Chinese. My name is Cao Dongliang. So the children call me Cao Lao Shi. I'm the Mandarin teacher of year 6 and year 7. Okay, here is my email. So if you have any question about your children's learning in the children's Mandarin learning in year 6 and year 7, so feel free to contact me with this email. So in case any issue that out of exception, so if your Wi-Fi disconnects, so we will close the meeting and try to attempt to rejoin. And in case the sound issues, please ensure your mic is off. And if you have questions, please add to the chat box. There is a Q&A page at the end of the presentation. Okay. Thanks for your cooperation. Okay. The expectation of this workshop is as below: to know some general history of Chinese character, to learn some stories behind Chinese character, to learn a few simple Chinese characters, and to know how to help your children's Chinese learning. We have 4 expectations of this workshop. And this workshop is under the school mission. We are bilingual because of a new language and the core value mindful, and this position curious about the language, about anything, any stories, his stories behind the language, behind the character. Before starting the workshop, here's a question: why learn Chinese language? Why learn Chinese language? When we see such a question, so normally the answer may be related to maybe the future career development, maybe for business, maybe for the self development. But today I will talk three reasons that we not often mentioned. The first one is the learning Chinese language can improve the artistic skills like painting, like drawing. And the second one is learning Chinese can help improve the brain power. And the third one is learn Chinese is not difficult as we think. It's because maybe some of you, maybe some of the children, they ever thought they want to learn Chinese, but they think, oh, Chinese is too difficult for me, so just stopped. So what I want to say is, learn Chinese is not difficult as we think. So why these three reasons can be the reasons that we learn Chinese language. I hope that after this workshop, we will get some ideas why these three reasons can be the reason that learn Chinese. If you think, oh, this is correct, that means my workshop, my section is success. If not, maybe I failed. Okay, I will try my best. This page, general introduction of Chinese character. You can see here, this is a Chinese character, and the top part, the part on the top, is a pinyin, which means the Chinese pronunciation. So how to pronounce this word, this character, and this part is a Hanzi. That means Hanzi is Chinese character, and this word, the meaning is here, is good. So three parts: pinyin, character, and meanings. However, if you read a Chinese book, you will find that there are only Chinese characters on that book, like here. Okay, this is a page of a Chinese book. There are only Chinese characters on this page. No pinyin, no pronunciation, no meaning. And so this is the difficult part. Normally, we think Chinese is very, very hard, very difficult to learn, because it not shows you the pronunciation. It's not like English or Chinese. So we can, like English or Thai. So if we see a word, maybe we don't know the meaning, but we can read it out. And we can read it out. But for Chinese, that means if you learn a Chinese character, you need to remember the pronunciation of it and also the meaning of it. So this is the difficult part. And this part is the part that we're going to discuss. Fun way to learn Chinese. Here we will focus on the Chinese character part because it's quite a wide topic. So learn Chinese character, the fun way is learn the history before learning Chinese. We should know what are we learning. And the children should know what are they learning. It's just, just go to learn, just step into the class and sit down, just learn. So what are we learning? To learn the history, how it comes, okay? And the second one, learn Chinese character by learning the story behind them. So every Chinese character has a story behind it. For example, this one, okay, this one is hao, it's good. It has left part and right part. The left part is a nü means female, the female, and the right part is a son, that's a child. So the meaning of this word is a female, a woman has a son or has a daughter. So that means how good. That's because in the ancient time, if the family has a boy or has a doctor, can be a doctor, that means it's good for this family. It has a good meaning. So they will feel very happy. See the story behind how this character. Okay. And the third one is learn Chinese character by drawing it. Okay. I will explain more about the third one, learn Chinese character by drawing it. This page is still the general introduction of Chinese character. Chinese character, the name of Chinese character we call Hanzi. That means Chinese character. The age of Hanzi is over 3,000 years. 3,000 years. Over 3,000 years. And we are still using it currently. The hometown of Chinese character, for sure, yes, is China. But the Hanzi, Chinese character, not only live in China, it also living in China, Korea or Japan. In the Korean language or Japanese language, you can see some Chinese characters. Okay. So they are under the influence of Chinese character. The population of Hanzi Chinese character. 3,500 is only the population of the common characters. It's only the population of the common characters. That means if you can remember these 3,500 character, you can handle everything in your daily life in China. Your education, your business, your self-career development, you can handle everything. The total number of Chinese character, it will be over 100,000. 100,000. But normally in our daily life, we only use 3,500. Okay, here let's see some the general history of Chinese characters. The Chinese character has a history of more than 3,000 years. Okay, it's a well known history, 3,000 years. But actually, it may be longer, because some symbols of 6,000 or 7 years ago. 7,000 years ago are found. It may be the earliest Chinese character, but it's still not well known. It's not systematic. So how Chinese characters were created is still unknown. Okay, we have many stories about how Chinese characters were created, but still we don't have a very certain origin of the Chinese characters. The most popular one is the Chinese character is created by this man we call Cang Jie. So you can see from the picture, this man is different with the normal people, right? Because he has four eyes. Maybe this is the reason why Cang Jie can discover more. The earliest systematic Chinese character is Oracle Bone Script. It's here, okay? Oracle Bone Script. This is the very earliest systematic Chinese character. As this kind of Chinese character kept on the animal bones or turtles' shells. It's kept on the back. And in the ancient time, it was used for divination. And now, still many Chinese still using this kind of turtle shell to do a divination to see, oh, will I have a good luck this year? The Chinese Research Center, many Chinese characters has been disappearing from the original one. For example, this one is the simple. So we know, oh, it's now we write it like this. But there are many still didn't disappearing yet. So the Chinese Research Center offer the rewards, cash rewards for disappearing one character. That means if you know which character is this one, you can get 500,000 bar for each character. But it's not a easy work. You need to do a lot of research. Here are some important changes of Chinese character. This is about 3,000 years ago. And this 2,500 years ago. And this about 2,000 years ago. 1,800 years ago. And this line is about 1,000 years ago. It's almost the same with the Chinese character that we are using now. It's almost the same. Okay, same though. It's after that dynasty, the Chinese character didn't change a lot. Okay. So after learning some history behind the Chinese character, now let's start to learn some story behind the Chinese character. The story behind the Chinese character, we will talk about the pictograms. There are many formations of Chinese character. So pictograms is one of the most important Chinese character formations. So what is pictograms? We can see here is a picture. So we can see the meaning related to picture. That means this kind of Chinese character came from drawing, came from picture. For example, this one is a sign, right? So it came to symbol, and then changed to the Chinese character. So let's watch a video. We can understand more about this part. Pictogram Chinese character. Shui, water. San, mountain. Mu,森林, forest. Cao, niao, bird. Lu, deer. Ren, person. Ren, person. Fish, yu, fish. Zhou, boat. Wang, net, wang. Tian, farm. Tian, farm. He, soil. She, house. Quan, dog. Ri, sun, yue, moon. Huo, fire, yue, music. Okay, so this video shows us how Chinese character, how the pictogram Chinese character were created. Maybe this is the way how Cang Jie, who create Chinese character. Now, let's learn more. Let's see more examples. And I will show some words that we are learning at, that we learned at school and the way how we teach this Chinese character. For example, here is a Chinese character. We will show the writing first, and then the pronunciation, how to read it. Sheng, this one is sheng. Okay, you can pronounce it and then show the meanings. Sheng here means birth or live or life. So why we write this kind of meaning in this way? And then we will show some picture here. This picture will show the reason why we write sheng like this. Sheng. Do you have any ideas? Okay, after maybe let's watch this video. Maybe we will get more ideas. Ideas why we write the sheng like this way, right? Sheng, let me explain it. sun here. So this line is like a little plant, sun, a little plant. And this is the leaf. This part is the leaf of the little plant. And this part, one line, two lines, three lines, these are the soil, the ground. So our little plant growing up from the underground, growing up, growing up. So it means sheng or birth. So this is the reason why sheng is read like this. This is the leaf, and this is the little plant. This part is the soil and the ground, growing and from the underground. So it's sheng, birth, live a life. Okay. And next one. This one a very simple word. Left, right is a Chinese character. So what's the meaning of this character? Let's see the picture. Go back to the history. Go back to the history. This one. Yeah, you have any idea of the meaning of this one? Let's go continue. Maybe from this one, you know the meaning already. Okay, 人 means people. 人 means people. Left, right means people. You see the left part in this picture is the arm, and the right part is the leg. The arm, the leg, it means 人, people. It means 人 and people. And another one, this one, 天. Tian, okay. Tian. Oh, you can see some part of Zhen in this Chinese character, right? Zhen is in this Chinese character. So what's the meaning of this one? Let's check from the picture. Tian, a person stand under something. Here is a line. Here is a square. So what's the meaning? What's the meaning? The meaning is sky. Tian means sky, sky. A person stand under the sky and look up. Okay, open the arms. That means sky, Tian. So Ren is in this Chinese character. Tian, sky. And the next one, Zhi. Zhi. What's the meaning of Zhi? This is the Chinese character. Let's check from the picture. Zhi. Oh, we mentioned before, right? Zhi, this is a sun. At the beginning, it's a round shape, and it then change to the, like the four square, like a square, and then change. Finally, it come like this. So Zhi means sun. It's the shape of the sun. I know it's not looks like a round shape because it's changed thousands of years. Okay, from the round shape, change. Finally, like this, it's Zhi. And Zhi can be date because we see the sun one time. Okay, it's sunrise and the sunset means one day. Okay, this one, Yue. Yue, what's the meaning of Yue? Let's check from here. This is the present Chinese character. Go back to the history. Go back. So can you get some ideas from the picture? Yue means moon. The original meaning of Yue is moon. This is the shape of the half moon. Half moon, right? This is the half moon. And then at the beginning, maybe it's a symbol. And change. Finally, we write Yue like this. It's the shape of half moon. And the Yue also can be the meaning of month, because the shape of the moon changed every month, monthly, right? Change monthly from the full moon, half moon, and then full moon. So that means 1 month passed. So Yue, the original meaning is moon, and also can be month. Okay, next one. So this word is a combination of Zhi and Yue. Zhi and Yue. The Zhi, we can see Zhi here is the sun, and the right part is the Yue. So our sun and moon, a sun and moon together, what's the meaning? A sun, 日, this part, 月, half moon, what's the meaning? The meaning is bright, bright, because the moon disappear, the sun will bring bright to the day. That means 明 can be bright. If we put 明, the orientation of sun and moon, if we put 明 and 天 together, 天 just we mentioned, 天 means sky, right? A person stand under the sky is 天. So we put 明, 天 together, we got another meaning. We get another meaning. 明 and 天 means it's not a bright sky. 明天 is tomorrow, tomorrow. Okay, because if we see the sun one time, we see the moon one time, that means one day passed to go to another day, go to the next day. So 明天, the meaning is tomorrow. Okay, let's try to review the five characters that we mentioned. Sorry, it goes quite fast. I hope that you can catch some points. So we just mentioned these five characters. Do you still remember the meanings? It's maybe we can't, yes, we can't remember the pronunciation, but how about the meanings? From the easiest one. This one is 人. What's the meaning of 人? 人 means person or people, right? Arm and legs. 人, arm and legs, this people of is people. 人. This one is moon, the shape of half moon, right? Moon. This one, 日 is sun or day or date. It's the shape of the sun, even if not a round shape anymore. This one, 天, what's the meaning of 天? A person stand under the sky and look up. It means sky, 天, sky. And this one, 明, a sun and a moon together. It can be bright or 明天, tomorrow. Okay, that's five characters, just very basic Chinese character. So how more Chinese character be created? Let's check from this one. 人, 人 means people. It can be radical, some part of the, it can be a part of Chinese character. This one, this word, you see, inside the square, there is a person. There's a people through the square. The out square, the square is means door, a door. People go passing the door. You look from your home. And at the gap from the, between the door, someone passed the door means very fast. So this one, shan, means flash. A person passing the door. And this one is zhong. Three people, ren. One, two, three. Three people together, this means a group. For example, ting zhong, the listeners. So you are the listeners of me, the ting zhong, group of the listeners, 听众, three people together is group, 众. And this one is 休, means rest. Why is rest? You see, the left part is a 人, person, and the right part is a 木. 木 means tree or wood. So a man lean against the tree. That means he wants to take a rest. A man lean against the tree. This one is xiu, rest. So this is how more Chinese characters be created. We have the basic one. We can create more. So how words be structured? Ming, tian, okay, ming is bright. So ming tian, tomorrow, another day. Ming yue, yue means moon. Ming, bright. Ming yue, bright moon. Sheng, means birth. Zhi means date. So sheng zhi, birthday. This one, Tian Sheng. Tian is a person stand under the sky. Tian Sheng, Sheng means birth. So to be born with some gift, Tian Sheng. And this one, Ren Sheng. Ren is a people. Sheng, to live a life. Ren Sheng, this means alive. And these five words are structured based on the five characters we mentioned before. These five. I created use these five characters. We structured more Chinese words. So let's see more examples. More examples. How a Chinese character was structured, created. Now this one is a mu. Mu means wood or tree. Is the shape of the tree, right? Mu is the shape of the tree. Is the body part, the leaf is the mu. So how about two mu? This one is two mu together. This means group. Group means several trees together. It's a group. It's like a very small forest. So three mu together is forest. Three mu together is forest because many trees. Together means forest. So, mu, lin, sen is the basic on the mu. We can create more Chinese character. And still mu, the radical mu. This one, what's the meaning of this one? Try to guess the meaning of this one. You see, the middle part is a mu. The middle part is a mu. There are some fruit on the top. On the wood, on the tree. On the tree. What's the meaning? So this meaning of fruit. Fruit. You see the head part. There's some fruit on the tree, right? So means fruit. Guo. And this one is he. He means the seeding. He miao. It's a kind of plant, right? Kind of plant. And this one is the leaf. The leaf. And this one, a mu, we put a line at the bottom, a line at the bottom. So it means the roof of the tree, the roof of the tree. The meaning of this one is foundation, ben, foundation, because this line means the roof of the tree. So the meaning of this one changed to foundation, ben. Okay, more examples of men, door. This one is men, door. It's the shape of the door, the shape of the door, men. So it's, I think it's easy to find, right? It's the shape of the door, men. So this one we just mentioned, shan, flash, a person passing the door, a person passing the door. Next one, this one in Chinese we say chuang. Chuang, the inside part is a ma. Ma means horse. A horse breaking the door. That means chuang. So the meaning is break in. The horse breaking the door. That means break in. Chuang. And next one, wen. You can see a mouse inside. A mouse in the square. A mouse. Wen. You open the door, open the mouth. What happened? Ask. Ask. If you want to ask something, you need to knock the door and then ask. Maybe ask the way to some place. So this one is when. A mouse in the door. When. Okay, let's guess the meanings. I have more examples. Let's try to guess the meanings based on the Chinese character. Okay. Try to guess the meaning. This one, shui. It shows in the video already. You have any ideas? What's the meaning of this character based on this picture? Shui, it means water. Water. This is like a river, right? So shui means water. Okay, more examples. How about this one? Niao means. Let's check from this picture. Do you have any ideas? What's the meaning of niao? Maybe not yet. More? Yes, niao means bird. Niao means bird. Niao is from the drawing. Next one. San. San. What's the meaning of san? From this picture, we can see it's the shape of mountain. Yes, it's the shape of mountain. So san means mountain. Three mountains here, right? San. And the next one, zuo. Zuo. What's the meaning of zuo? It's like we mentioned that this is Zhen, right? This is Zhen. This is Zhen. So two person. Two person. Zhen. So what's the meaning of zuo? What's the meaning of zuo? More? Zuo. So zuo means sit. Zuo means sit. Sit. Two people sit against each other. Okay, 对面坐. Okay, 坐. Sit. Here we showed more examples of Chinese character. Hope you maybe I'm not sure. Do you have remember some simple Chinese characters like shan, mountain, or the person? Yes, the arms and the legs. That one is Ren. Ren. Okay, it's almost time's up. 3 more minutes. So, the forecast of learning Chinese. So, how to help the? That's the just I talked. That's the main part of this workshop, the Chinese character. So, how to help the how to help your children to learn Chinese? The first suggestion is the Chinese teacher should focus on teaching character after teaching pinyin. So, this part is teach pinyin. We teach pinyin first. And then, once we know how to pronounce pinyin, we will try to forget it. We will not use it because we will focus on the Chinese character. This is the most important part. I know some of the children, they learn Chinese at home. They have the tutor at home, maybe at some tutor center, right? So the parents, please tell the teacher to focus on the Chinese character, because I have met some Chinese learners, not in our school, some learners outside, they learned Chinese several years, but they still can't write or read because they just read the pinyin. So every word just has the pinyin. When they read this word, they just read the pinyin. They don't memorize the character. Okay, the second one, Chinese character is difficult to learn, but it has easier way to learn. It has easier way. So please try to encourage your children to learn. Okay, you can explain the history, the story behind the Chinese character. And the third one is learn the story behind each character. So every Chinese character we has the story. So once you know the story behind the character, that will be much easier for the children to memorize the character. And this next one, try to draw it out. So, oh, this one is hao. Left part is a nü, female. Red part is a zi, son. So, can you draw a female on the left? Draw a son or a doctor, a child on the right, based on the Chinese character. And then you can do the writing. So, writing is very necessary, but we will not directly go to write it. Because you directly go to write it, we don't know what's the structure, what's the story behind the character. So it's just copywriting. It's not make sense. Okay, it will be too difficult to memorize. And next is the dictation. Dictation, we do dictation at school. For example, I will say how the children need to write down the character and the meanings and the pinyin. So the parents, maybe you don't know how to read the pinyin. You can tell the meanings and let the children to write down the character and the pinyin that they learned. These are a kind of dictation. Okay. You can tell the meaning. For example, good, good, and let the children to write the pinyin and the character of the good. Okay, so my workshop almost finished here. Let's back to the three reasons that we need to learn Chinese. Improved artistic skills and improve the brain power is not difficult as we think. Do you agree with this? Maybe yes, and maybe not. Okay, I hope that for that you can get something from here. Here is some work shows from the children's writing work. 月, 今天, 明天, that we learned from that basic Chinese characters. Sorry, it's time's up already. Okay, sorry, maybe several minutes. If you have any question, you can ask now. Dear parents, do you have any question? Okay, if not, my section will be finished here. Okay, so we'll have a 5 minutes break, and then the next section will start. Okay, it's Huang Lao Shi. Okay, so thank you, with Kapunka, thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Cao. So I'll take over from here. Okay, can you hear me? Yes.
Yes.
Okay, I'll take over from here. Thank you. Okay, so dear parents, we'll start the next session very soon. We are now having a 5 minute break. Let's come back at 15 past two, okay? So just maybe 3 more minutes now, okay? Let me set up the screen and we'll start very soon.
Excuse me, while waiting, may I ask one question? Whether the thank you. Whether the session is being recorded.
Yes, this session is recorded.
Right, thank you. And how can we access it later?
Actually, there will be a feedback form you have to fill in, and you can put your emails in. I will send the slides of both the presentation and as well as the recording for today.
Right, because I might need to drop off before the end of the session. That's why
Oh,
I'm asking, just to make
that's quite
sure.
all right. That's okay.
Okay,
Okay.
thank you.
So dear parents, if you need to leave this workshop anytime before we finish, please do because this session is recorded. I will send a video for everyone who sign in this the workshop today. Okay, let's start. Okay, hello everyone. Welcome to our Chinese workshop. So before we start, I want you to make sure that your microphone is working. You can you should mute yourself during our workshop, okay? If you have any question, you can click the button, raise hand button. It's just below in your Google Meet. And once you finish asking your question, you can click again, say lower hands to put down your hands, okay? If you don't feel like saying anything in the chat, that's okay. You can just type your question or type your opinion in this chat box. Okay, it's all on your screen. If you would like to access to more information about this workshop and any other information, please do send me the email. Okay, I'll leave this email on the screen. You can see it right here. Okay, I'll give you some time to write it down if you want to have more information about the session. Okay, let's begin. Okay, so hello everyone. My name is Huang Chang. Okay, I'm the Chinese teacher of year 4 and 5, and I'm also the head of the Mandarin department in ANS. You can reach me in this email. I'll leave it on here. Okay, so I will be presenting from now till 3:30. I think it's before that because I designed this workshop a little bit longer than I originally had. Okay, so you can just stay until the end, or you can leave this workshop before the time. Okay. Okay. Today's agenda, I'll be sharing these 3 points with you. Okay, is Chinese as hard as it seems? And the second point is, what are the effective ways for our children to learn Chinese? And the third one is how parents can support our children in learning Chinese, okay? I'm hoping my workshop is not just me presenting all the things to you. You can ask me anything during the session, or just type your question in this chat. Okay, I'll also answer your question very soon. Okay, so let's begin. The first session is Chinese as hard as it seems? Before I tell you the answer, let me share with some common questions that a lot of parents ask me regarding to their children's Chinese learning. Okay, so let's see some of the questions. The first one, what is pinyin and hanzi? Sometimes we call hanzi the Chinese character. And why should our children learn both of them? Okay, I'll share the answer with you later. The second one is, how many years or to what level should my children, should my child learn to be able to speak Chinese fluently? This is a very popular question among the parents. Number three, if my child continue with his or her Chinese learning, what opportunity can he or she get in the future? I get this with a lot of higher year groups parents. And number four, my family has Chinese ancestors, maybe great grandparents, their grandparents or great grandparents. Okay, can his or her grandparents teach my child how to speak or to write Chinese? Okay, these are the four questions that I can think of right now for, you know, some parents constantly ask me. Okay, I give you maybe four more questions. Does any parents want to ask me anything more before I explain? You can type your question to the chat box, or you can just unmute yourself to ask me any more questions. Anyone? Sorry, I need to explain that. Huang Chang, ก็คือหวังเราชื่อเรียกผมว่าหวังเราชื่อก็ได้นะครับคือวันนี้ผมขออนุญาต present workshop ครั้งนี้เป็นภาษาอังกฤษเป็นหลักนะครับถ้าสมมติผู้ปกครองท่านไหนอยากจะถามคำถามที่เป็นภาษาไทยก็ตามสบายนะครับเพราะว่าผมก็พอเข้าใจนะครับโอเคแล้วก็อันนี้ section ต่อมาก็คืออันนี้คือคำถาม ที่ผู้ปกครองมักจะถามก่อนที่ลูกหรือหลานของทุกท่าน คือมามาเรียนภาษาจีนนะครับแต่ว่าถ้าสมมติมีคำถามที่นอกจากนี้ที่อยากจะถามผมก็ตามสบายนะครับถามได้นะครับโอเค so any parents want to ask me any more questions let me explain in the you know the last part of our workshop anyone okay if not that's okay I will go on with our workshop okay for the first question what is pinyin and what is hanzi or the chinese character should our children learn both of them okay so before I explain this I think mr Cao in section one just explained what is hanzi and what is pinyin but let me tell you this again so the writing or the chinese character we call it hanzi and the pinyin is the pronunciation of the hanzi the answer is yes we should learn both because let me show you how chinese student learned this word when there was like in the very young age as you can see they also need to learn how to write this character or the hanzi many many times as you can see they have to write many times okay until they can write it without looking at the words okay in our school for my children for my students I also give them something like this some of the parents may say that oh This is a little bit boring for the children. I would say yes, but they need this repetition to be able to remember it, okay? These are for the year five students, but for the year four student, for some student, they still don't have the ability to, you know, write it a lot of times like this. So maybe they will start from just drawing, maybe coloring the picture and just try to write this character one time. Okay, so this is for the lower ability kids, I would say, okay, or the lower year groups. If they still, oh, 老师, this is too hard for me to write, they also have these kind of exercise to be able to, you know, to read this hanzi and see the meaning okay so parents don't worry about this homework they do have a lot of homework about this writing if not writing they will need to be able to read the words like in some other forms okay so this is the first part yes we need to learn both pinyin and hanzi in this at school okay the second question is how many years or to what level should my child learn to be able to speak Chinese fluently? This is a lot of Chinese a lot of parents ask me this question. Before I answer this, let me show you a very interesting thing. It's called the FSI or the Foreign Institute, okay? This institute it's based in US. They categorize you know foreign language into five category. For the English speaker, Chinese is the category five or the hardest language for them to learn, which they need to spend 2,000 something hours, as you can see here, to learn Chinese okay we are learning Mandarin Chinese as you can see Mandarin Chinese is one of the language we haven't learned anything about a Cantonese Chinese is Pasa Guangdong but we're not learning it at school okay this as you can see is very hard for the native English speaker but for our student most of our student is Thai native Thai people I will say it's a little bit easier for them to learn Chinese because there are some similarity between these two languages I'll show you later so how many words do we need to learn I can tell you that the average Chinese people can remember around 3,500 characters if As a language learner, if you learn up to 1,000 something to 2,000 characters, that means they can deal with the every day-to-day situation. There's a test that every Chinese learner take to determine your level. This is the HSK test. Is that you can just remember it as the Chinese level test. Okay, altogether there are six levels. It's roughly the for the Chinese learner, they take this test to roughly examine how what ability that they can use. Okay, I would have to explain that if a Chinese learner, I think they need to get to level six before they can speak this language very fluently. This is a very, very long goal. I would say if you have to start from the beginning, level one, all the way to level six, I would say it needs at least 8 to 10 years to get to the last level. For them right now, I think if they learn in school, only in school, there's no like outside institute for them to learn extra. I will say 1 year of learning, they will get to level one to be able to use very simple words and phrase. If they spend 2 to 3 years, they can get to level two, maybe level three. Okay. If any parents are familiar with the a test in our school, it's called the IGCSE Chinese. Okay. Some of the students in year 9 and 10 take this test. Okay, I will say if you pass the IGCSE Chinese test, it's equivalent of HSK level 3 to 4 right here. Okay, so I would say learning Chinese is very different from be able to speak fluently in English, because I will say after a few years of learning English, the kids can say something already. But for the Chinese learner, they need to spend a lot more time than that. Okay, so that means if you ask the children, so what did you learn about some Chinese? Can you say something in Chinese already? In most cases, the children still cannot say a sentence or converse very fluently with a native speaker. That's the very normal in this case. Okay, so this is just some interesting fact that I found. A lot of parents want to know how well their children can speak in Chinese already, and sometimes the children cannot say much in Chinese. That's normal. Okay, so just give the children some more time before they can reach the to be able to speak Chinese. Okay, any questions to this? No? Okay, let me pass to the next slide. For the third question, if my child continue to, with his Chinese learning, what opportunity can he get in the future? I will say nowadays in Thailand, there's a lot of scholarship to learn in China. If they pass the HSK test, which I show you just now, the HSK test, if they pass level four, most college or most university, they will provide scholarship for them to learn free, maybe 1 year or all 4 year free in China. In Thailand, there is an institute. It's called Confucius Institute. Goku Samakom Kongzi. It's in the Chulalongkorn University. They also provide scholarship if you pass the HSK test. If you pass level four, they will provide maybe 1 year. If you pass level five, they will provide like better scholarship. Okay, I would say there's a lot of opportunity for them to learn in the future. But as you know, nowadays, China has become a superpower, so everyone want to learn how to speak Chinese, and maybe we're hoping that our children can be using Chinese in our, you know, future jobs, or maybe just make some Chinese friends, something like that. I think this is very useful. Please make sure your child learn Chinese. Okay. And for our next question is, my family has a Chinese ancestor. So can his or her grandparents teach my child how to speak or write Mandarin Chinese? To answer this question, I would say yes and no, because you have to know exactly what kind of Chinese that your grandparents is speaking. In this map right here, let me show you. This is a map of all the dialect in China. As you can see, we are learning Mandarin Chinese, which is the majority of the Chinese language. As you can see, Mandarin is in the middle part of China. But for our, you know, for your grandparents, for the children's grandparents, I would say most of them are come from Daejeo, right? In this area, actually, Daejeo, in this map, it's in this area, in the Cantonese or Yue speaking area. Okay, they speak a dialect of Daejeo, but it doesn't show in this map because it's a very, very small dialect. I will say this dialect, it's very close to Hakka and Minnan dialect. Okay, let me show you some example. In Pasa Daejeo, you do the counting, but tick do sa si, chame. Okay, but in Mandarin Chinese, we call it 一二三四. It's completely different. Okay, it's completely different. Maybe some of your ancestors come from Cantonese, or we call it Pasa Guangdong. Again, this is another dialect in Pasa Guangdong. Now, let me show you the example. We do the counting like 一二三四. It's completely different. It's I would say they are unintelligible to each other. Okay, so if you say, can my grandparents teach the kids? Yes, but make sure they speak Mandarin Chinese, not some dialect first. Okay, and this is the speaking. As for the writing, let me show you these two different systems. Actually, in Chinese, we have two different writing systems. The Mandarin Chinese, the ones that we're learning is called the Simplified Chinese. Simplified Chinese, it's used after about 1960s, after, you know, Mao Zedong was become the leader, and he wanted to improve the literacy of the Chinese people, so he made it easier. But for your grandparents, for the ancestor who moved to Thailand many, many years ago, I would say most of them still use traditional Chinese, which is, as you can see, it's harder in writing. This is just some example for you. So if you want the grandparents to teach the grandchildren to be able to write, make sure they can write in the simplified Chinese, because today in China we use simplified Chinese. Where still use the traditional Chinese, it's only in Hong Kong and Macau and Taiwan, if you are interested. Okay, so this is the fourth question. Any other question before I move on? Any other questions? Do I speak too fast? No? Okay, let's continue. So, is Chinese as hard as it seems? Back to our original question. I will say yes and no, but let's take a look at the pinyin first. Before the kids learn how to write a character or the Hanzi, they need to master the pinyin system first. Okay, I would say the pinyin system is not hard as we thought. Okay, because it has three parts. They're called initials and finals and tones. For the initials, it's 23. They are very similar to the consonant in English. Okay. And for the finals, 38 finals, they're very similar to the vowels in English. In here, in this word, the A sound is the final or sounds similar to the A sound in English. Also, we have something called tones. I will say this tone is not difficult because they are quite similar to the Thai tones. Okay, so usually the children, when they begin to learn Chinese, they will spend about 1 month, sometimes 2 months, to master this pinyin system before they move on to the writing. If any parents think that, so my kids is still behind in this pinyin system, please do send me an email. I have a lots of different apps for you to try to, you know, improve the children's pinyin. Okay, and also we have passed the pinyin learning for the year 4 and year 5 students. I think they are doing quite well in this pinyin learning. So let's pass this part. Let's go to our next part, which is a big part, Hanzi or the Chinese character. In the last section, Mr. Cao has explained there are pictogram, or in Chinese we call it 象形字. So it means literally means the Hanzi with the writing like the object. Goku pictogram, goku look lang zemen sing nan kong sing kong anan. Okay, I'll show you more example. The second big part is called the ideograms, which similar to the pictogram, but it's combined two or more pictogram to suggest a third meaning. This is also very easy to understand. I will show you more example to this ideogram. But the main part in the Chinese character is this one. It's called the picto phonetic compound. Don't be, you know, scared by this big word here. Picto is just the pictogram, and phonetic is the sound of the word. So basically, this compound or 形声字, we call it in Chinese, it's composed with at least two parts. The pictographic part suggests the meaning of the word, and the other part is called a phonetic part. It suggests the pronunciation of the Hanzi. I will show you more example of this one later, okay? I can tell you that this part, the picto-phonetic compound, takes up more than 90% of all Hanzi. That means if we master these words or these compounds, that we can master 90% of all the Hanzi, okay? So let's see what are they. I'm going to show you three words in these three categories. Okay, the first word, pictogram, in the last section Mr. Cao has explained it already. This is a word mu, which means a tree. So because as you can see it looks like a tree, right? Yeah, so this is mu. So it's one word, one meaning. We call it pictogram, and it looks like the tree as well. Ideograms means maybe two or more parts combined together, but they're basically similar to the pictogram. As you can see, this word is lin, or the woods, because it's two trees combined together like this. It's become lin, or the woods. Okay, these two, I will say it's very interesting to learn, but most of the word is not made up like this. Most of the word in Chinese is not like this. Most of the word is this compound. It's called the picto-phonetic compound. We have to break it down a little bit. So let's see the lower part here. This lower part is the picto part. Mu suggests that the compound means, or in this category of the tree. See, this is the tree, and this word has the tree. We call it, sometimes called it radical. So this word have the tree radical. That means it belongs to the group of tree. And the upper part here, it does not have the meaning, affecting the whole word, because this is just the phonetic part. The upper part here is pronounced jia. It don't worry about the meaning, because it's only suggesting it sounds like the word jia. As you can see, this word is jia. It sounds like jia, yes. So this whole word, as you can see, when we look at this word, when we see the wood or the radical, tree radical, all we know is this belongs to a tree part. And this word on the upper part here, if you know the pronunciation, you can kind of guess, oh, this sounds like jia, or the whole word, it turns out to be jia, the shelf, right? Because as you know, the shelf is made out of wood, right? Or the trees. Okay, so this is most Hanzi is made in this way. But for our kids, how do they learn about this system? So let me show you to the next part. What are the effective way to learn Chinese? Okay, so what is the ways to learn different part? What does different part means? Okay, let me show you. So I will break it down into three main parts. The first part is to get to the bottom. Okay, so to get to the bottom. Let me back to this word ma. Some student just say, oh, 老师, I know this word because it's horse, right? Ma, I have learned it already. 老师 taught me at school already. If your kids can answer the meaning of this word, I will say, good job, but not enough. Okay, why? Because as a language learner, especially Chinese language learner, we need to learn more than just looking at the writing, be able to read it and know the meaning. No, there are more to that. Okay, let me show you more. First of all, we need to know what is the radical, or as I explained already, it's the pictogram or the pictographic part of the word. So this ma does not have a separate radical, because itself is the radical, it's the horse radical. I'm going to explain how you can check out this radical with some tour, okay? And also you need to know what the structure is for this word. This word here, ma, is a single body structure, because as you can see, you cannot separate this word like the left, right. No, you cannot separate the up, top, bottom part, you cannot. So this is a whole word together. It's called a single body Hanzi or Chinese character. And you also need to know how many strokes this word has, okay? 1, 2, 3. Okay, if you can count, make sure the children also, look into the strokes as well. And also you need to know the stroke order. There's a tool later. I'm going to show you how to check this stroke order out. So this is the first stroke, second stroke, and the third stroke. Okay, so make sure you know the stroke order as well. And also, in the lesson, I will show them the origin of the word. So for this word, ma, as you can see, this is a horse, slightly changed into this one, and then this one. And today we write like this, okay? I will say this part here, it's a very interesting part for the kids to know that, oh, each Chinese character have a long history. It's not just, oh, we write like this today. No, you need to know the whole history of the word. Okay. Also, one more thing I asked my children to do is can you do some creative drawing? For example, can you, redesign this Hanzi into a picture to see, this is a horse, right? Can you make it more like a horse again? You can add something, add the Ming, or maybe add some stripes to make it like horse, ma. Okay. So, as a parent, how can we help the children to get to all these extra steps? I will say it's quite hard, but it's possible. I'm going to show you two different apps or two tours for you to be able to help the kids. For the parents right now, if you have a device that you can use, I want you to try to type in this website right now. It's called the dictionary.writtenchinese.com. I'm going to show you on the screen later, but you can look at the website right now. This actually, this one and this one are similar in using, but this one is a web page one. I'm going to show you later. If you want to download, you can also download this app. It's called Pleco. You can use an iOS or Android system to download this app, okay? Let's try to see if these words are the words that the children are learning today. How can they use this app to find out more meanings to each word? I'm not going to show you the answer right now. So parents, I suggest you type in this website right now and then see if you can find out the meaning of these words, okay? Right now, I'm going to show you on my screen right now. Show you in a different screen. Okay, so once you open this website, you will see something like this. Actually, it's a dictionary website. So for the first word, nan, if you cannot type the Hanzi or the Chinese character, it's very easy. You just type the pinyin nan, and the tone is the second tone. You just type like this, N-A-N and two, and then you search for that. Okay, just wait. Okay, as you can see, there are quite a lot of, one, two, three, four nan words. Okay, which nan is the one that I asked you to check out? It's this one. So you click here, learn more. And then it will show every single detail of this word. Let me just give it 1 second. Yes, it's right here. So as you can see, to be able to learn a little bit more about this word, once you use this website, you will see something like this. First of all, you can see the the stroke order of this word. How many stroke? You can click here,
nan,
to listen to the pronunciation nan. Okay, or you can pause and resume the the stroke order. But I think the best part is this part. It literally break down the word into the small parts that you can just remember it as a story. I would say it's easier as a story. So basically the word nan is male or the man right here. So what makes it a man? Because as you can see, the top part here is tian or the feel, and the lower part here is power or li. So what is nan or what is a man? A man basically is to to use their they use their power. Okay, in the field. Okay, so this is it also suggests the responsibility to be a man to use his power in the field to grow some crops maybe. Okay, so this is the first word. So basically we can use this way. Let me show you back to our original slide. So right now I'm going to give you some minutes to can you use this tool to check out some more words. Okay, so right here, try to use this website. It's free. Okay, and then can you check in any of these words? Remember, if you cannot type this pinyin or the Hanzi, you can just type like this, N-A-N, like two, the second tone. Okay, right now I'm going to give you two minutes to check out some of the words, see if there's any interesting that you find. Okay, let's give it some time. Try to use the technology to learn Chinese. Okay. Okay. มีผู้ปกครองท่านไหนมีข้อสงสัยหรือคำถามอะไรที่เกี่ยวกับเว็บไซต์อันนี้ไหมครับถ้ามีunmute ได้นะครับถามคำถามตรงนี้ได้แล้วครับ anyone
ค่ะรบกวนถามนิดนึงนะ
ครับ
เราจะช่วยอธิบายตรงเอนานกับนานหนึ่งกับเมื่อกี้ที่ตลอดที่ถูกค่ะ
ได้
ขอบ
คร
ค
ั
ุ
บ
ณมาก
ครับจริงๆนะคำนี้นานถ้าเขียนในพิงยิงนะก็คือเขียนอย่างนี้ n a n ใช่ไหมแล้วก็จะมีเขาเรียกว่าอะไรจะมีวรรณยุกต์อยู่ข้างบนใช่ไหมครับแต่ว่าถ้าใช้แอปอันนี้นะครับใช้เว็บเพจอันนี้นะครับจะไม่สามารถพิมพ์อันนี้ได้เนาะแต่ว่าเราก็พิมพ์ไปเพราะอันนี้คือเสียงสองถ้าเด็กเขาเรียนภาษาจีนหรือพิงยิงมาแล้วเขาจะรู้ว่าอ๋ออันนี้คือเสียงสองใช่ไหมครับแต่ว่าในเว็บไซต์อันนี้นะจะพิมพ์ว่า n a n แล้วก็สองแล้วก็เขาจะออกมาเป็นแบบหนานมีคำไหนบ้างแล้วก็สามารถจะหาคำว่าหนานเขาจะมีน่าจะมี3-4อันเพราะว่าเขาเรียกว่าอะไรคำพร้อมเสียงในภาษาจีนก็มีเยอะนะครับแล้วก็ลองดูว่าหนานอันนี้คือคำไหนแล้วก็กดเข้าไปใน learn more แล้วก็จะสามารถดูได้ว่าจะมีรายละเอียดอะไรบ้างนะครับ
ใช่โอเคขอบคุณค่ะก็คือ
ค
หม
ร
ายเล
ั
ข
บ
ทุกมุมเสียงในพิมพ์อ
ใช
ิง
่
ถูก
ครับ
โอ
ถู
เค
กต้องครับหมายเลขอันนี้ก็คือก็คือเสียงวรยุทธ์นะครับ
ได้ขอบคุณมากค่ะ
ครับโอเคตอนนี้ผู้ปกครองทุกท่านลองใช้เวลาสัก2 นาทีแล้วก็ลองเช็คลองลองใช้เว็บเพจอันนี้นะครับลองดูว่าคำเหล่านี้มันแปลว่าอะไรหรือจะมีสตอรี่อะไรบ้างครับ
ขออนุญาตถามอีกครั้งหนึ่งนะครับ
ครับครับ
คือพอดีผมเมื่อกี้ drop off ไปสักพักหนึ่งกลับเข้ามา
อ๋
จ
อ
ะชวนแต่ถ้าเกิดพูดไปแล้วไม่ต้องซ้ำก็ได้นะฮะผมก็หนึ่ง
คร
ห
ั
ม
บ
ายความว่าถ้าเรามีแค่หันซึ่งคือหมายว่าแค่มีตัวอักษรจีนเนี่ยเราก็จะใช้นี้ไม่ได้คือเราจะต้องมีตั
อ
ว
๋อ
ที่ตัวกำหนดเสียงด้วย
จริง
อย่างนั้นใช่ไ
จ
ห
ร
ม
ิง
คร
จ
ั
ร
บ
ิงแล้ว
คืออาจจะใช้ได้แต่ถ้าเรามีความรู้ด้านภาษาจีนจำกัดเราก็ต้องหาตัวพิมพ์หรืออะไรมันจะยากใช่ไหม
อ
ค
๋
ร
อ
ับหรือเราไม่มีแป้นพิมพ์
คืออย่างนี้นะครับผู้ปกครองคือในระบบภาษาจีนนะในระบบเขาเรียกว่า iPad เนาะเขาจะเราจะสามารถใช้แป้นพิมพ์2 อย่างหนึ่งคือเขาเรียกว่า Chinese แบบ handwriting ก็คือถ้าเรารู้แค่ฮั่นจื้อหรือตัวเขียนตัวอักษรภาษาจีนจะเขียนออกมาแบบในแป้นพิมพ์เขียนออกมาเลยตัวนี้แล้วก็จะสามารถหาคำนี้ได้นะครับแต่ว่าถ้าสมมติเวลาเราไม่แน่ใจว่าคือเราไม่คือเรารู้แค่เสียงหรือความหมายเราก็สามารถใช้เป็นเขาเรียกว่าพิงยิงคีย์บอร์ดนะครับแล้วก็หาคำนี้ออกมาได้นะครับแต่ว่าวันนี้ในเว็บเพจอันนี้นะครับคือเราจะลองใช้เว็บนี้เว็บไซต์อันนี้แล้วก็พิงยิงออกมาก่อนลองดูว่าคำนี้คือคำนี้แล้วก็มีสตอรี่อะไรบ้างแล้วก็จะเราจะสามารถจะบอกเด็กว่าอ๋ออันนี้จะมีส่วนหนึ่งอันนี้แปลว่าอะไรส่วนอีกส่วนหนึ่งแปลว่าอะไรนะครับอันนี้ตอบคำถามได้หรือเปล่านะครับผู้ปกครอง
ขอบคุณครับขอบคุ
ค
ณ
ร
ค
ั
ร
บ
ับ
คร
ม
ั
ี
บ
คำถามนี้ตามมาเรื่อยๆแล้วกันเพราะว่าในหลายชั้นนะไม่ว่า year I think year 5 year 6 year 7 they all started Chinese Mandarin this
Yes
what would be the difference between let's say a year 5 class and a year 7
Okay actually this year is the first year for the year 4 and 5 to learn Chinese so they will be starting to use you know the pinyin or the writing key like they will start to learn how to write Hanzi and be able to speak the pinyin but for the year 6 and 7 they're also They're also the first year to learn, but I think their pace is much faster than the year 4 and 5 because you know regarding to their development, they should be able to write more Hanzi than the year 4 and 5 students. So Mr. Cao, who was presenting the section 1, he is teaching the year 6 and 7. He focused more on the Hanzi writing than these pinyin system, but I am teaching year 4 and 5. I would say for my student, they cannot you know, write this so well, so I need to teach them more about the pinyin or the pronunciation first. Is it clear?
Thank you so much, Lexi.
Okay, so I think this is the website that I introduced. Let me show you the result of all these following meanings. Okay, for the first word, nan, as I can tell you that the first part is the feel and the lower part is the power. Goku push ben push high no dong chai lang nai nan. Okay, the come to song. 闯，晶晶麦吉老师、曹老师个普通康尼有，然后个去康诺这边不读，那个康奈这边马呢？ It's a horse break into the door, so the whole word 闯 means to break into. And the third one 球, this is interesting because you can see this is a people inside, and there's maybe this is a wall for the people. Literally means to imprison. Okay, so people trapped inside this wall to in prison. Okay, and the next one, oh, I like this word a lot because you can see this is a tree and a tree, but lower part here is the fire. So it literally means to burn. So fire burning the tree to burn. Fen, we call it fen. Oh, 然后今年呢, this word, so anisiena means immortal or the fair a fairy. Tamai sien donkey ni poa nia simer japin con kwamer japin puhao. So literally sien is a person who live in the mountain. It's literally a man and a tree. So goku konti pak you to rest pak pon. Okay. So if you use this tour and then make sure you check every word. Actually, in my lesson, I also asked the children to find out more about this word. Maybe this is just some example. Using this website, they love this. They love this action because they know more to this, you know, one single Hanzi or one single character. Okay, so let me just leave this page for maybe 5 more seconds. I'm going to use another one. Okay, so I think the second, you know, way to, you know, to teach our children to be more, you know, to be better in Chinese is more input or more exposure. I strongly recommend this app, Quizlet. It's a word card app. You can download it for free. It's very good. You can sign in, or if you don't want to sign up, that's okay. Let me show you how to use this Quizlet right now. Actually, for my student year 4 and 5, I will give them Quizlet every single lesson, every single week. They love to use this app in terms of, you know, it's a word card. But for me, I'm very, very old fashioned. I think that if they can make some word cards out of this Quizlet app, it's better because they can use that word card to stick in their room, maybe stick in their, you know, on their computer, on their table, anywhere to be able to see, okay? So right now I'm gonna show you how to use this app. If you can also search in Google Quizlet, you will see something like this. I'm going to show you right here. Okay, so once you go into this app, you will see something like this. Actually, this is a set. Can you see it? This is a set that some other teacher make, but we can also learn this from the set, okay? So once you go into this app, you will see a flashcard, learn, write, spell, and test, okay? And this week, for my year 4 and 5 student, they learn about the Chinese zodiac. So you can see it's the zodiac, Kokulasino. Okay, so first, you can just click in here, the flashcard, and they can flip, and then they can also listen to the sound.
老虎.
So this is a sound, and if you think, I remember, you can pass to the next one, the rabbit.
兔子.
Something like this, okay? Once they go over all these, they can click the next button to learn. So what is this word? 猴子. I can, if I remember, I can click, it's correct. Chicken, it's 鸡, but if I remember wrong, it will show you, you have to study this one again. Okay, so I think this is a very good way to learn this again, like outside of the class. Also some other bottom. I think this one I'll just share a little bit. For example, sheep, a goat, they need to find out the word, the character, something like that. After all they have learned, there's a test for them. They need to, for example, Zhu is C answer, something like this. And once they finish, they can check their answer. See if I got it correct, it's maybe right here. Yes, see, it's Zhu is correct. Anyway, so after this, they can also play this game. It's called the match game. So basically, they need to connect the word with the meaning. So let me finish. So once they finish all these, they will have a time. The best way is, the best thing about this app is, if you log into this app, it will show you, like, what's the score for others. As you can see, year 5, Testo, he do this only 6.4 seconds. Is in the leaders board is number 2, so they can also see who is number 1 and who is like higher or lower in their rank. Okay, so this app I will strongly suggest the parents to use it. But for me, this app is not only for this functions. The very good function is you can literally use it to print out the cards. Let me show you how to do that. As you can see here, the 3 dot here, you can choose print right here. So there's different ways to print out the card. I would usually use this large picture right here. And then you can just alphabetical or not print pictures. And then you open this PDF. And then you will see the printing options. Okay, so this is a very good way for you to, if you say I want my child to look at the words when they are home, please print it out and maybe let themselves to cut it and then stick it wherever they want. Okay, so this is the app. Let me go back to my presentation. So for the year 4 and 5 student, they are already learning how to use this Quizlet app already. I think if you just, tell them, can you show me more about this app? I think they are the experts, okay? So let me go back to the slide. Okay, another way, another app that I want to share with you is called the Plukit. I recently find out this is also a very good app that people can use in this app. Okay, I sometimes make this Plukit. It's a game website. Okay, you can use it to review and to review the words that they have learned on that day. Let me show you how to make a blue cat game. Let me show you with the entire screen here. Okay, so how to make this blue cat game? Actually, you need to use this Quizlet that I just showed you. For example, this is a set of words that you want the kids to learn. First of all, you need to click here, and then you click this export button. And as you can see, oh, this is every word that the student are going to learn. So you copy the text right here, and just you can leave this page now. And you go to this website, it's called thebluekit.com. But first of all, you need to sign up an account, but I already got an account, so I will click log in. Once you log in, you will see this is your set. Okay, and as you can see, I have made different sets already, but you can go over here to create. Once you go to this create section here, you can just make, this is the Zodiac. So I'll name here Zodiac. Since this is, you know, you have to link it to the Quizlet. So you click here, link it with the Quizlet, and you create your set. And you click next, and then next right here. This is, right now, you just Control V to paste all the words that you just copy. And then you add question. So it will generate a set of questions very fast. See, this is all the words. And then you can save this set right now. So right now, you can see your own set right here. How do you do it? It's simply click here to... you can also play a solo game, but I haven't tried this yet. You can play this host game here. Actually, in this website, you can see there's a lot of different game mode. I would say if you choose this racing game, I think the kids love this racing game, and you click host, and you click host now, and then you all you have to do is you use another device to go to this website, and then you put in this ID pin, and then you will see your name here, and then this is a game to, you know, to answer the question that you just learned in the Chinese that you learned. Okay, so this is another website. I have put a video right here. I will also send you how to make a blue cat game with this app, with this link. Okay, so this is it. And then let's go on to the next one. So as a parent, how can we support our children in learning Chinese? Besides the apps that I told you that you should try, there's some basic questions or something that parents usually ask the kids to do. Okay, let's see if you fall into these categories. So instead of asking the student like this, how do you say this word or phrase or sentence in Chinese? You can try to ask in this way. What is the newest word or phrase or sentence that you learn? Why should we ask like this instead of like this? Because as I explained, Chinese, it's very difficult to put it in a sentence. And for the kids, they're still learning it, you know, for their first year or the second year, I would say they still cannot put the answer in a sentence yet. Okay, so instead of asking like this, you should just try to use, what is the newest thing that you learn? Okay, so instead of asking them, can you answer this question only in Chinese? Maybe you should try to let them answer like this. Can you answer the keyword in Chinese? Can you answer maybe one word or two words in Chinese for this question? Okay, same reason, because the student cannot say a full sentence yet. So I suggest you don't discourage them to say something in a sentence in Chinese. Instead, you can just let them answer one or two or some keywords in Chinese. Okay, some parents may say, oh, you only need to speak Chinese in the future. Just learn the pinyin well if you think Hanzi writing is too hard. Some parents look at the homework or some exercise that their children are doing. It's a lot of Chinese Hanzi writing and they think, oh, maybe this is too boring or maybe it's too hard for my children. They can just learn how to say it. I would say you should let the children try to write Hanzi because try to tell them it's fun, okay? And it's the interesting part to learn more about this character, not just the pronunciation, okay? And the last question is, if you say you shouldn't use any device when you learn Chinese, you should only write the Hanzi many, many times to be able to remember it, I would say you can just try to embrace the technology by saying, oh, we can try to use some apps to learn Chinese in different ways. So in today's workshop, this is all the points that I cover. I think that I'm doing most of the speaking in here. There's not much interaction between me and the parents. So I want to finish this today's workshop by a Chinese saying. It's called a journey of the thousand miles begin with a single steps. So right now your children is taking small steps, okay? But don't worry about that. They will get very far from now on. Thank you for this workshop. So for the last maybe 5 minutes or so, I want to give it as a Q&A section. But if you don't have any question, you can just scan this QR code or you can type this webpage. Please try to give us some feedback. Also, if you would like to know more things about Chinese learning or how you can help your child in the Chinese learning, please leave your email in this feedback form. I will send a follow-up, materials to via the email that you send me. Okay, so that will be all for me today. I hope you enjoy the workshop. It's quite fast. I know it's quite it's a lot of information. It's a lot to take in. But please leave me some message or feedback. So thank you. You are welcome to leave this workshop right now. But before that, try to scan and give me some feedback. Thank you. Is there anyone still want to ask me anything about Chinese? ก็คือสำหรับวันนี้นะครับเวิร์คช็อปครั้งนี้ก็คือเสร็จสิ้นแล้วครับแล้วก็ถ้ามีคำถามอะไรเพิ่มเติมก็สามารถถามได้นะครับตอนนี้มีผู้ปกครองท่านไหนอยากจะถามอะไรไหมครับหรือข้อสงสัยอะไรก็ได้นะครับโอเคถ้าไม่มีก็ขอบคุณสำหรับวันนี้ที่ทุกคนที่เข้าร่วมในเวิร์คช็อปครั้งนี้นะครับถ้าสมมติมีเวิร์คช็อปครั้งต่อมาที่เกี่ยวกับChinese หรือหัวข้อต่างๆนะครับแล้วทางโรงเรียนเขาจะส่งทางอีเมลแจ้งอีกครั้งหนึ่งนะครับ
ขอบคุณมากค่ะ
ขอบคุณมากนะครับ
ขอบคุณครับ
ขอบคุณมากนะครับโอ้เชี่ยเชี่ย Who is that พาอ๋อพาI'll see you online next week. I'm back online from next week.
Yay!
Yeah? I miss you guys. See you. Bye-bye. Oh, is it Andrew?
谢谢老师,
再见。再见啊,再见。Bye-bye. Okay, so if not, I will leave this chat right now. Thank you for your participation today. Please scan this and send your leave your email in this feedback. I will send you a follow-up information if you are interested, or if you do have any other questions, you can also leave in this feedback form. Okay, thank you. I will leave this chat right now.